Fairy Tales, written by Charles Perrault, narrated by Dan Stieber. Bluebeard. Once upon a time, there was a man who had fine houses, both in town and country, a deal of silver and gold plate, carved furniture, and coaches gilded all over. But unhappily, this man had a blue beard, which made him so ugly and so terrible that all the women and girls ran away from him. One of his neighbors, a lady of quality, had two daughters who were perfect beauties. He asked for one of them in marriage, leaving to her the choice of which she would bestow on him. They would neither of them have him, and they sent him backward and forward from one to the other, neither being able to make up her mind to marry a man who had a blue beard. Another thing which made them averse to him was that he had already married several wives, and nobody knew what had become of them. Bluebeard, to become better acquainted, took them, with their mother and three or four of their best friends, with some young people of the neighborhood to one of his country seats, where they stayed a whole week. There was nothing going on but pleasure parties, hunting, fishing, dancing, mirth, and feasting. Nobody went to bed, but all passed the night in playing pranks on each other. In short, everything succeeded so well that the youngest daughter began to think that the beard of the master of the house was not so very blue, and that he was a very civil gentleman. So, as soon as they returned home, the marriage was concluded. About a month afterward, Bluebeard told his wife that he was obliged to take a country journey for 6 weeks at least, upon business of great importance. He desired her to amuse herself well in his absence, to send for her friends, to take them into the country if she pleased, and to live well wherever she was. "Here," said he, "are the keys of the two great warehouses wherein I have my best furniture. These are of the room where I keep my silver and gold plate, which is not in everyday use. These open my safes, which hold my money, both gold and silver. These my caskets of jewels, and this is the master key to all my apartments. But as for this little key, it is the key of the closet at the end of the great gallery on the ground floor. Open them all. Go everywhere, but as for that little key, I forbid you to enter it, and I promise you surely that, if you open it, there's nothing that you may not expect from my anger." She promised to obey exactly all his orders, and he, after having embraced her, got into his coach and proceeded on his journey. Her neighbors and good friends did not stay to be sent for by the new married lady. So great was their impatience to see all the riches of her house, not daring to come while her husband was there, because of his blue beard which frightened them. They at once ran through all the rooms, closets, and wardrobes, which were so fine and rich, and each seemed to surpass all others. They went up into the warehouses, where was the best and richest furniture, and they could not sufficiently admire the number and beauty of the tapestry, beds, couches, cabinets, stands, tables, and looking glasses, in which you might see yourself from head to foot. Some of them were framed with glass, others with silver, plain and gilded, the most beautiful and the most magnificent ever seen. They ceased not to praise and envy the happiness of their friend, who, in the meantime, was not at all amused by looking upon all these rich things. Because of her impatience to go and open the closet on the ground floor, her curiosity was so great that without considering how uncivil it was to leave her guests, she went down a little back staircase with such excessive haste that twice or thrice she came near breaking her neck. Having reached the closet door, she stood still for some time, thinking of her husband's orders, and considering that unhappiness might attend her if she was disobedient. But the temptation was so strong, she could not overcome it. She then took the little key and opened the door trembling. At first, she could not see anything plainly, because the windows were shut. After some moments, she began to perceive that several dead women were scattered about the floor. These were all the wives whom Bluebeard had married and murdered, one after the other, because they did not obey his orders about the closet on the ground floor. She thought she surely would die for fear, and the key, which she pulled out of the lock, fell out of her hand. After having somewhat recovered from the shock, she picked up the key, locked the door, and went upstairs into her chamber.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.